Hello everyone, Nadim here with PC.Solutions.Net. So today let's talk about one of the service delivery areas that we have in our MSP practice. So let me switch over the screen now. I'm sure everybody remembers this little diagram I drew out last time. We've been talking about it last couple of videos. So today we're going to talk about this guy right here. And, how does that fit in? How does that work? So I'll give you an example. A lot of times what happens is we get a customer, let's say we pick up a customer where we have maybe a and let me just make that smaller, go over here. So we have we pick up a new customer and we start doing the net admin and the VCIO process, the technology alignment process. And let's say our net admin finds out that the cabling is in really bad shape at the customer site. So that is what becomes a project. So the net admin, and this is, a standardized process that we have. So the net admin has a standard form that they go through, and it's a real simple, yes or no type form that they have to do. And the idea is to standardize it, to make a process out of it, to minimize subjective thinking around that and make it more objective. So once that form comes out to a VCIO, let's say, the cabling is in bad shape. So now the VCIO will kind of get with the customer and find out, for example, let's say if the customer is going to, go from 20 users to, let's say, 30 users within the next 6 months, if that's the business goal, well, that cabling is not going to support it. So we need to do something about that cabling. So now the VCIO comes up with the cabling project for the customer. And, if it's a task that we do in-house, we will quote it and go through the process for that. Or maybe it's a task we don't do in-house, like, for example, cabling. Let's say we don't do cabling in-house, but we have a subcontractor that does the cabling. And so we get the cabling team in there. And, of course, after the customer approves the project, we come in as a standalone project. So that's how this project part works in our MSP practice. Of course, the net admin, the VCI, these are the proactive parts. The reactive part is a support part, which we included in there. And the idea is to minimize the reactive part. So how does that play? So if our cabling is now in good shape and it's all certified for a certain bandwidth and we've tested it out, that's going to reduce the reactive support ticket load because we're not going to have issues related to cabling anymore. And this may be related to switches or routers. We've had instances where some customers had routers that were no longer under warranty. You couldn't even renew warranty on these routers. They were so old, such old appliances. So if something did happen to one of these appliances, this customer could expect to be down for days while a new appliance is shipped out to them. So these kind of things come out in the net admin process, and that's how we're able to minimize the reactive ticket. So that's how that works. And just wanted to touch a little bit about what that project is. And these are all kinds of problems. I mean, there are app dev projects, cabling projects, server migration projects. I mean, so there's a lot of those kind of one-off projects that are in this section right here. So next, I know I've touched a little bit on centralized services, but next time I'll talk more about centralized services, and hopefully that will make it better for everybody to understand how our MSP practice works and what we do and how we are different from everybody else out there. Over the past 20 or so years, we have kind of figured out how to run this practice. We know the metrics. We know how to track the metrics. We track them religiously. It's a math thing now. It's not really like a English major thing, like, you know, where you have to write drawn out paragraphs and that's a subjective thing. It's not like that. It's like a math equation for us now. I mean, it's like one, two, three, and then, you know, on the other side of the equation we have four, five, six. I mean, it's that, you know, that's how we've got it down. So yeah, everything is a process, everything is standardized. The easier you make something to track, the more you will track it. And we make sure and track these metrics. Yeah, I mean, these are not an optional thing. We have to track them. You know, certain things that we do based on these principles have really transformed our business. I mean, otherwise, you know, we would either be sold out to somebody by now, which a lot of IT companies do out there, or we would be out of business. I mean, it's, you know, that's what's, if you're not tracking it like a math problem, you're not, you know, you're not going to make it. And it's just, that's the way it is. You know, next time, let's talk a little bit about the centralized services. There's a lot that goes on over there. These are things that happen on the back end that customers don't see. You know, projects, you see it. You see new hardware, you see new cabling, you see new services or new, you know, like a website, maybe that's a project. So you see these new things. Centralized services is something that you don't see. And a lot of times, you know, people ask me, they're like, well, you know, okay, you're charging us this much, but what are you charging us for? If you can minimize those tickets, those reactive tickets, then what are you charging us for? Centralized services. That's how we are minimizing your reactive tickets, is because there's a lot of automation and processes and AI that works behind the scenes to minimize those reactive tickets. So we'll talk a little bit more about that next time. Until tomorrow, everybody have a good day and be safe out there.